Okay, so here I am for the breakdown of episode 15 of Twin Peaks, season 3. This episode left me a little cold. Apart from a few scenes, it wasn't really an episode which I think moved things along. And even though I'm very aware that this show may not necessarily wrap up all the different plot tie-ins that it may have to season 2 and 1 of the show, and even to Firewalk With Me, I feel that on a certain level it's missed out on a lot of opportunity to move things to a point where I don't feel as unsatisfied as I do now. I'll refer to my phone for references as to what it is that I think was good about the show before I really go into the nitty-gritty of what could have been better about it. Nadine has restored her faith in being selfless, something that we've never really seen of her. She's been quite a selfish and manipulative character, and due to Dr. Amp, aka Dr. Jacoby's show, she's now realized that she's been holding back the potential happiness that Big Ed Hurley can have with Norma. And that was quite wonderful. Normally in a show, I kind of want to see a character realize what they're going through and how they can actually make their life better through continual knocking their head against the wall kind of thing, meeting an obstruction and learning how to deal with it either through some character's advice and then maybe ignoring that and then going forward and then at some point being a better person. We kind of didn't really get that from Nadine in terms of her going through something, because she's not really the main character of the show, so I can forgive that. And just because of the quirkiness of the show, I don't think it doesn't have to adhere to certain rules of storytelling. But it was good to see Nadine take that long walk and then tell Big Ed Hurley exactly what it is that we've been wanting her to realize for over 2 decades now. But we never thought we'd get it, because she is quite a stereotypical, I wouldn't say evil, that's way too hardcore, but she's definitely not someone that we thought would actually become more than the intermediate character than she is. She's actually learned something. So that was good. Evil Cooper goes to the convenience store and he asks about Judy. I've been behind on this because I was doing a bit of research, and Judy is in fact what the internet perceives to be anyway, is a nickname for Garland, the father of Bobby Briggs. Garland Briggs is his real name in the show, and Judy is a reference to him, i.e. as in Judy Garland from The Wizard of Oz. So that was either Albert's pet name for Major Briggs, or a name that's been afforded to him by other characters, but that's who Philip Jeffries is alluding to in terms of telling Evil Cooper, or rather not telling Evil Cooper exactly who he is. I think my main issue with this episode is that there isn't that much for me to really talk about, so it's kind of difficult to process in relating it to you, so forgive the stumbling of my words today. Let's see, who else do we have? Richard Horn has been brought back into the show via him following Cooper, and has now been abducted by Cooper to go who knows where. Not much to say about that, because Richard Horn, we're now in episode 15, and Richard Horn isn't necessarily, again, a character. He's just seems to be going through what the script wants him to, and it really does depend on us, the audience, to really glean any interest from him by us reading into things. You could say it for a lot of the show, but I feel that for Richard Horn, there's not much going on anyway. So there's that. Let's see, who else do we have on my phone? Stephen, who was beating up Shelley's daughter. He may or may not have committed suicide in a frustrating scene because we didn't exactly hear what he was saying. It was like lots of odd confessional moments or gruntings. And maybe someone out there can tell me exactly what it is that he was supposed to have said. But he may not be with us anymore. Let's see, James Hurley. God, I feel bad for you guys, because normally I've got quite a few things to dissect, if I may say so myself. But James Hurley walks into a bar and expresses his need to talk to Renee, who has a husband who is an oaf and beats him up. And then you get James Hurley's friend, who for now called Hulk Fist, who basically beats up the aggressors of James Hurley. Again, like, you could squash all the elements of this episode into a much shorter episode if you wanted to, and add more plot in, I think. Why they've slowed things down, I don't know. Maybe perhaps the last three episodes are going to be a big roller coaster and this is just ratcheting us up for that moment. We shall see. Okay, so Chantel kills the guy in Las Vegas who's been calling the shots on behalf of an unseen entity who we can only determine to be Evil Cooper. And then she has a nice sit down with Tim Roth's character, very much like the part in Pulp Fiction when they're Tim Roth's character and his girlfriend, who he calls Honey Bunny, is preparing to do some kind of like a robbery in the store. It had that kind of conversational kind of stream of consciousness to their talking, which has always been part of their dynamic of the show, but not necessarily one that moves the plot forward. Finally, who do we have? Dougie Cooper is inspired to put his fork into a socket, and hopefully this is the beginning of Dougie Cooper going to the Black Lodge, perhaps reacquainting us with good Cooper. Let's hope so, because the episode really does need something like that. Something that will give me something to do other than do strange things to the camera. Okay, that's how uninspired I was by the episode. Alright, now, Audrey is being inconsequential, so I'm not even going to go there. But Log Lady, it was really sad to see her die. We don't see her die on screen, but we definitely know that she's passed away. It says something about Lynch's relationship to the actress Margaret Lanzmann that he can actually use the real fact that she is passing on from cancer as a plot point in the show, and to give her, a rather heartfelt ending. To actually have that relationship with an actor, to have their trust so completely, must be a very unique experience that he shared with us. So that was good. And before I go, I wasn't sure if it was Mark Frost who was playing the character of the guy walking through the woods who noticed Stephen dying or about to shoot himself, as inferred. So if anyone knows, let me know. But anyway, for now, that's all you're getting. So may you have a fantastic week until we meet again.